them and fastened their feet in stocks. If Paul and Silas had let their perception rule their perspective, then where would they have left them? Still locked up. They have been mocked for miles by a demon-possessed girl. They have been publicly ridiculed, beaten with rods, all because they cut someone else's preconceived notions and cut their money. And people start acting crazy when you start messing with their money. But through it all, Paul and Silas did not let their perceptions mess with their perspective. Even though they were locked up and locked down, they refused to be a prisoner of their perceptions. Some of us are still prisoners of our own perceptions or our preconceived notions. Pre means before, right? But that is the devil's playground. See, we felt like we may have should have been in one place by now in life. We should have been married by a certain time in life. I should have this job by that time in life. And all the time, we came up with our preconceived notions without ever consulting God, without ever praying and asking God, God, what is your perspective for my life? I got one question, and I'm almost done. I got one question for you today. Have you lost your perspective today? Remember, perspective means the capacity to view things in their true or relative importance. Are you tired of running the rat race and running in circles on that spiritual hamster wheel? Are you tired of trying to figure out your own way? Which way is up? Which way is down? Which way is in? Which way is out? I stopped by to tell you today, and I stopped by to help you gain some perspective, but not just some perspective. I stopped by to help you gain the perspective. Let's work with those five senses again and show you how God wants to give you some perspective. See, earlier I gave you man's five methods of perception. So now here is God's five methods of gaining his perspective. Hearing. Start listening for the sound of victory in your life. Why? 1 Peter 2 and 9. But ye are the chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye shall forth his praises of him who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Start seeing, since number two, yourself free. Because he said in Jeremiah 29 and 11, for I know the thoughts that I have towards you, said the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you an expected end. Then once you hear the sound of victory and you start seeing yourself free, I can sum up the last three senses in the beautiful words of that beautiful song of Jacqueline Carr. The touch, the taste, the smell, all of that, everything that is attached to me wins. My family wins. My finances win. My church wins. All those crazy people on my job that don't even realize, I should say on our job, that don't even realize the reason that they are winning is because God loved us enough. He loved me enough to help me gain his perspective. So instead of them walking around talking junk about us, having secret meetings, trying to figure out how to get us out, they should be happy that God has placed us in their life, because everything attached to us wins. Hallelujah. Everything attached to us wins. See, verse 27, the jailer says, and I'm getting ready to show you. Verse 27, the jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted, don't harm yourself. We're all here. The jailer called for the lights, rushed in, and what did he do? Fell trembling before Paul and Silas. So then what did he say in verse 30? Again, Because we got God's perspective. Get ready to show you how everything attached to us wins. Verse 30, he says, "Son, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. And you and your household." Everything attached to them, everything attached to me, it wins. Hallelujah. Verse 32. Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and all the others in the house. Yes. Then what happened after that? After that, the jailer's perception lined up with God's perspective. Mm-hmm. Verse 33 and 34. At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. Mm-hmm. Then immediately he and all his household were baptized. The jailer brought them into his house and set a meal before him. He was filled with joy because he had come in to believe in God. He and his whole entire life. Want to know what happened? He gained God's perspective, and everything attached to Paul and Silas, which was then attached to the jailer, they all won. No longer was the jailer a slave to his own perceptions. No longer was he bound by his own preconceived notions. See, my view or my perception says nothing. That it, all it shows me is that no one loves me.
Right.
All that we see around us is that my perception always shows that the odds seem stacked against me. It seems like it shows me all the time that I'm lost. Seems like it shows me that I'm always stuck in my own foolishness. See, we have got to stop letting our own perception rule God's perspective. Oh, and when we gain God's perspective, that is when the reality kicks in. And then I am the head and not the tail. Because I gain God's perspective. I am above and not beneath. Because I gain God's perspective. I am the lender and not the borrower. Because I did what? I gained God's perspective. At that point, I'm going to sum it all up and tell you, I am then the bomb.com. Because I gained God's perspective. I don't want to miss what God has for me because I am stuck in my own preconceived notions. When I look around me sometimes, all I feel like I see is death and destruction. We turn the news on and all we hear is about the shootings and Trump did this and Trump said that. Yeah. You want to know why? Because we get stuck in our own preconceived notions. When I retire, God is telling us, gain my perspective. Yes. It's right there in front of you. Start seeing yourself winning. Start feeling yourself winning. And before you know it, you'll feel like, good. I taste the victory. I smell the victory. Why? Because I gain God's perspective. It ain't always easy. It ain't always easy. Because we're human. We're human. And we get stuck in our feelings. You know, that's what they say about us women. We get stuck in our feelings all the time. I'm all up in my feelings. I can't hear you because I'm in my feelings. But guess what? In your feelings, you're in your own preconceived notion. Your feelings don't matter to the kingdom of heaven. It is all about God's great perspective. Shed your preconceived notions. Spread your preconceived notions and gain God's perspective. And once you gain God's perspective, everything attached to you will win. Everything attached to you will win. Sometimes the people that are around us, they don't understand it. They don't get it. It's the reason why things may not be failing for them, things may not be falling apart for them, is because you got someone in your presence who is attached to God and who is trying to gain his perspective. And they should be grateful. Shed your own preconceived notions and gain God's perspective. When you gain God's perspective, you will hear him say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. We all want to hear him say, well done. God, my child, you gained my perspective. My child, you worked for me. You did what I asked you to do. You shed your preconceived notions God, if there's anyone in our midst right now, God, that is stuck in their own preconceived notions, can't figure out how to get out, God, can't figure out which way to go, God, they feel lost, they feel stuck, God, they just want to feel your presence, God. God, I ask right now, God, that you touch, God, their heart. God, that you touch their minds, God. God, that you give them your perspective so that everything that is attached to them will win, God. Move right now in a mighty way, God. And we thank you. God, we thank you. God, we thank you. God, we thank you for never taking your perspective from us, God. And we will forever give your name all of the glory, all of the honor, and all of the praise. And we all said amen. Amen. I have no idea why God changed. I didn't know why. I was studying one thing, and then yesterday morning, I woke up, and notes from this fell out. And he said, this is what I need for you to remember, and this is what I want you to share with my people, because you've forgotten that I have a perspective for you. I have a plan for your life. You're there for a reason. You're there for a purpose. I want you to share this, my children, my friends, my family. Gain God's perspective and a hold on tight so that everything attached to you, it will win. God bless you in the name of Jesus.